relationship. I stopped saying I've got to wait for good things to happen to me, and I said I'm going to grind. I'm going to fight. I'm going to work. I'm going to press toward. I'm going to learn. I'm going to do everything in my power every single day. I'm going to do everything in my power to become a victor and not a victim.
What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Patrick, and in today's video, let me get into better lighting. Is that better lighting? Hold on. I know I'm like 174 now, but like, where the hell are the abs at, guys? Okay, anyway, whatever, never mind. So today's video, it's gonna be like an add-on to my leg day of how I'm gonna grow my legs by changing my genetics, by basically not using genetics as an excuse, and by training hard as fuck twice a week. So this is that second day of the week. Right now it's Sunday, so usually I would rest Sundays because of the one leg day a week, but you know, we trying to get these fucking chicken legs to tree trunks, so we can't be resting out here. So today's leg workout is going to be heavy deadlifts in the beginning, going for a one rep max, hopefully going to be 4 or 5. We're going to work our way up, but I've been having this super, super weird like type of neck injury strain where it's like the back of my neck feels like muscles being super stretched and it's super, super painful. I didn't have any pain with it doing squats or any other stuff, but when I did have pain was it with like on a hack squat machine. I'm not sure why. I think because it pushed my shoulder down, so it had my neck stretched and that was really painful. So hopefully that doesn't act up today. It did hurt a little bit during my pull day, but it wasn't that bad, so hopefully we can avoid that. I've been stretching it all day, but you know, we're just gonna have to pray. But it's getting later. I'm gonna pull up to the gym around 8 o'clock, and we're gonna take some hefty pre-workout because 405 ain't no joke, man. Four wheels on that deadlift bar. If you guys know me, I've only been taking deadlifting seriously like the last 6 months, so 405 is a huge milestone for me. And my PRs on deadlift have been absolutely flying, and my numbers on deadlift, you know, flying. So hopefully we can keep up that same energy and hit this 405. And then later on in the workout, after the heavy deads, we're gonna do some high volume front squats with less weight. So I'm thinking like 3 to 4 sets, 10 to 12, maybe even 15 reps on the front squats. Absolutely destroy our quads, and then work on over to accessories, which I'll show you guys all of that. But yeah, so I was busy, you know, usually I work out earlier in the day, but I was busy today with family stuff. So that's why I'm heading over to the gym now, which is like 7:30 right now. We're gonna get there closer to 8. And then we're gonna have to take some melatonin tonight, which I'll show you guys when I get back, because taking dark energy at 8 p.m., like maybe I'll edit this video till 6 a.m., who knows, but it's gonna be hard to sleep after that. So I haven't really had a pre-workout meal. I just had a couple oatmeal cookies, and that's it, because I want to go in with somewhat of empty stomach so that, you know, I don't have food squishing around when we're squatting and deadlifting, and I want this pre-workout to hit me fucking like a truck. So I'll show you guys taking that pre right now, and then we'll head over to the gym. All right, so pre-workout for today. I know it's going to be 8 p.m. when I work out. Don't give a fuck. We got melatonin for a sleepy time after. We got to wake the fuck up to hit this PR. So, boom, dark energy. Now, one thing I will say about dark energy, best tasting pre-workout I've ever had. Honestly, you mix it with water. Usually I raw dog my pre's, but I heard a couple horror stories about this, since there's so much caffeine and so much DMA that some dude passed out when he raw dogged it, whatever. I normally raw dog pre-workouts when they're not that strong. Since this one's pretty strong, I'll just mix it with water, drink it on my way to the gym. Better safe than sorry, but let's check out the ingredients. All right, so basically just the pump product, the usual stuff, but then we gotta get into the goodies. So DMAE, which is like a little bit less DMA, obviously, 750 milligrams. Then we got caffeine, 400 milligrams. Then we got DMHA, 200 milligrams. Then we got that wicked stuff, DMAA, 60 milligrams. Now, this is gonna be fucking crazy. I've taken it before. I haven't taken a full scoop. I was a little bit scared, so I was kind of pussying out on the full scoop. I was going like half, then I did 3/4. But if we want to hit 4 or 5 and we want to destroy our legs, we got to do a full one. We can't cheat this one. So splash that in the little bit of water we got here. Ooh, look at that mist. Smells, doesn't smell that nice, but it tastes amazing. Best pre-workout I ever tasted. So if you're mixing it with water, this is the best tasting one for sure. And now I'm gonna drink this, we're gonna head over to the gym, and I'm gonna pick it up there. So basically, this is me hitting those front squats. Now I'm using this cool little rogue bar where you rest it on your back, and then basically it, you know, emulates the same as the front squat without having to worry about balancing it like on your shoulders or whatever. So I just want you guys to listen. You know, I said I was going all out with this leg training. I just want you to listen to me hit these fucking weights and really push it on this workout.
Two more.
And then I hop over to this little leg press machine. Normally I do this hack squat or I do the regular leg press, but I don't know what was going on, guys. Like, this neck strain is really like pissing me off and really getting in the way. So this machine, you know, allowed me to hit my leg still on like a leg press kind of type and not really, you know, tax my neck and not really feel that strain at all. So that's good. And basically I just banged this out for 12 to 15 reps. And then after that, I did this little circuit of like the quad extensions, the seated hamstring curls, and then I did a superset with the calf raise. At this time, like, as you can see, I'm wearing a hat. You're probably wondering why the hell is this guy wearing a hat, but basically, like I said, I was getting like pretty bad headaches, and that neck pain was really, I guess, contributing to it. So I kind of wanted to get rid of the lights in the gym so that I wasn't beaming on my head. But yeah, I'm gonna need to evaluate like the caffeine I'm taking, because if it's gonna fuck with my workouts, and then like if it's good once I hit strength, and then it gets to like shitty once I hit hypertrophy, that's definitely a problem, and that's something I need to sort out for sure. So we're definitely gonna have to
no one's gonna push you
evaluate that. But yeah, so you guys know that first kind of the first leg day of the week, I was doing it one at a time. That was just to get a better mind muscle connection on with my hamstrings and with my quads. And then now on the other day, since we did high volume squats already, we're gonna just work towards getting that weight up and down and still feeling the stretch and still feeling the squeeze, of course, but just not going as slow. And we're gonna work together with both legs at the same time. And then, yeah, so basically we're just doing three sets, 20 reps on the quad extensions, 20 reps on the hamstring, the seated hamstring curls like this. And I was actually feeling it really, really good with the seated one. Usually I do that lying down one, but it was feeling nice with the seated. And then we work on over to the calves, the seated calf raise here. And I'm going a bit heavier than I usually do, just because in my earlier leg day, I went, you know, 20, 30 reps closer to failure. So here I'm going a bit heavier, and I'm just going to train it, you know, in that 10 to 12 rep range, and really kind of go heavier so that we're not just pumping out endless amounts of reps and feeling the burn here. We're going to try to build up some strength in the calves, train it a little bit different, train it as if it was any other muscle group, you know, try to get that growth going. All right, y'all, so it's the next day after, you know, that gruesome leg day, and basically I didn't really get it on the camera, obviously, but like my head was pounding. I need to cut back on the caffeine. I took a full scoop of that dark energy like you guys saw. But honestly now, like, I don't know what's happening to me. Before, I used to take like 400, 500 milligrams and be okay. Now, anything over like 300, getting closer to 350, I get crazy headaches. That little neck pain was acting up again. And it's weird because usually, like, I'm fine for my compound lifts during the beginning of my workout. Like, it's all good. I don't have headaches, whatever. I just feel pure energy and like full focus. So that's good. But then once after the compound lifts, after I go like all out exertion and I switch over to hypertrophy, that's when I get crazy bad headaches. That's when the neck pain comes back. That's when it basically all goes to shit. So I need to reduce my caffeine intake. And I was so exhausted after that workout, man. Like, we really pushed it, really tried to go to failure on everything to do with legs. So basically like full body, like I said before. But that was the workout, and it was a bit later. Like I said, I started at 8, so I didn't finish till around 10:30, and then I had to drive home. And by the time I get home, I literally had a protein shake and just collapsed in my bed. I was exhausted, but it was a good workout. We managed to hit that PR, and that's basically it for this video. But I do want to tell you guys before I go a little tip on how to deadlift more. And basically, the way you want to deadlift more is just experimenting with conventional deadlifts and sumo. I always thought that, you know, conventional was the only way to do it, and then kind of like, it never really felt right. Like, the movement never really felt like perfect. I worked my way up to 315, but then kind of after getting to 315, like, my back would always ache and always be super tight, always be super sore. And then I switched over to sumo. I didn't have the flexibility for it, so I, you know, worked on a stretching routine. I was consistent with my stretching routine, and then that eventually allowed me to, you know, hit sumo properly. And once I did that, my deadlift exploded. Like, it felt so good, and it just felt properly, where I didn't feel like, you know, any type of tightness or stress on my lower back like I did with conventional. So now I do sumo and it feels good. I'm gonna be switching to a double overhand grip, as you saw in that clip for me deadlifting. I was doing like one over, one under, but I don't want to have a lat imbalance, so I'm gonna switch to double over. And then I might have to start using the wraps, because double overhand, it's really hard to grip the bar. So just gonna experiment a little bit with that. But that's gonna be a tip for you guys to deadlift more, is don't just go with what everyone else is doing. Try both, try conventional and sumo, and see what works best for you, and then go from there. So that's gonna be it for this video. If you want more workout videos, comment down below and let me know. Merch is going live probably within the next 2 days. Website's going live, gonna have training programs fully there. I'll make another video talking about it when it does go live. But thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.